Tibet, geographically one of the remotest parts of the world, was isolated from American and European contact until the 20th century. Early travelers told of a mysterious land and people. One of the most enduring visions of Tibet is as Shangri-La, a magical place free of pollution, greed, and warfare. Shangri-La was a fictitious monastery in Tibet, invented by author James Hilton in his 1933 book, Lost Horizon.
Welcome to Shangri-La. You see, we are sheltered by mountains on every side. A strange phenomenon for which we are very grateful.
His best-selling book was made into a hit movie. Shangri-La became part of the English vocabulary, meaning a utopian, exotic place. Despite its geographic isolation, Tibet had strong ties with its neighbors.
We know that Buddhist monks traveled widely to China, Mongolia. Chinese and Mongolians traveled to Tibet. Nepalese came to Tibet. So Lhasa, the capital of Tibet, was a very cosmopolitan place, and monks came from across the Buddhist world to study there. So the isolation of Tibet, to a certain extent, is a misperception. It was in the 18th, 19th century, certainly Europeans were not allowed to enter as freely as they would like, but Asians and people from Central Asia traveled to Tibet quite often, and trade was very brisk. There are bright and dark moments in Tibetan history, as in any other society. It's important to see the human side of Tibetan culture in order to understand its richness and its greatness.
In recent years, Tibet has attracted greater attention through Hollywood films and the increasing popularity of the Dalai Lama and Tibetan Buddhism. The exile of over 100,000 Tibetans to India and other countries has introduced Tibetan culture to the world. What's the famous city of Lhasa like today?
When people go to Tibet today, they will visit, for example, the Jokhang, the so-called Cathedral of Lhasa, and they will see people there dressed in various kinds of regional outfits doing prostrations. They'll often see people doing the four prostrations along a route with a big callus on their forehead. This is a very traditional form of Tibetan Buddhist practice. And Lhasa, despite all the changes that have taken place since the Chinese invasion in 1950, remains a potent place of pilgrimage in Tibetan Buddhism.
At the same time, Lhasa, once a spiritual utopia in the imagination of Westerners, is an increasingly modern city. In an ironic twist of fate, Tibetan culture now flourishes outside Tibet, as shown in this ceremony at the Asian Art Museum. For many people, Tibet's religion and philosophies continue to offer a sort of Shangri-La. They promise relief from the soulless commercialism and hectic pace of modern life. Despite all the changes in Tibet, Shangri-La remains strong in the imagination. Sehgi mo atoya sehzi.